This is my traveler's notebook, which I got from Bookbinders here in Brisbane. And I used it in my recent holiday overseas to visit family in South Africa. Now, let me just open it up. The first few paintings, sketches, were done for a traveler's notebook meetup at Bookbinders. And so some of these paintings were done prior to the holiday. I've since added a couple of postcards that I bought. This is my travel palette. I generally do that before I go away on a holiday, so that I know what colours are in my travel palette. I tend to change the colours quite often, so it's useful to have a reference. And then my pens that I have inked up, ready to go. And a look at the traveler's notebook with its little protective fabric pouch. Before the trip, I also did a map of one of the outings that I was planning, one to the Underberg area of the Drakensberg, to Castleburn Estate, or resort. Then the first weekend with my son and his family, we went to Cape Vardel. This is just the brochure from the wilderness area. We stayed in a log cabin. It's quite rustic, but rather charming. It's about 2.5 hours drive from Durban. The latter part of it is in a game reserve. This is a practice painting, if you will, of the Drakensberg, and a couple more. And then just before my holiday started, my granddaughter had a dancing concert. We presented her with a bouquet, and this was done, a very quick sketch, before we presented it to her. At the Bookbinders meetup, they had a beautiful orchid plant, which I painted for the people who were there, just to show them a couple of the tricks with watercolour. We also had the opportunity to play with these various travellers stamps sent by the Travellers Company. I was lucky enough to win this bottle of Edelstein Smoky Quartz. Here's my lucky ticket. You'll see when it's diluted, there are lovely gradations of grey and brown within the single colour. That ink is made by Pelican. Also done before I left, French and More, a local cafe, great favourite of mine. They did a makeover of their premises, and this was just a little section of the cafe. And here I am at last, waiting to board my plane, and this is a view of the plane out of the airport window. Then when I got to Johannesburg, I visited a niece and had to do a couple of drawings of her dear little rabbits. I spent time with my brother. We went to Kloofendal, which is a park or sort of wild wilderness area out on the way to Roodepoort. We had a good time catching up there. And then we also had time for coffee and cake and a quick sketch inside another cafe. Then on another day, we caught up with my great niece and had tea at Three Marys, 44 Stanley Street, Johannesburg. This is jumping around a little bit. On the trip to Cape Vardel, which was quite a long trip, I was sitting in the back. I had a view of the driver, my son, so I decided to do a sketch of him while we were going. As you can see from the lines, it was quite a bumpy ride, but fun to do nevertheless. At Cape Vardel, the log cabins are set in amongst the forest. This was the view from our deck. And this is a drawing that I did sitting in amongst the casuarina pine trees along the coast, along the beach. And the main beach and launching area for fishermen and their boats, at Cape Vardel itself, lots of colourful tents and gazebo type things alongside the seashore. I was fortunate enough to have a little bush buck meet me every morning early when I sat downstairs having a cup of tea. This little buck was so tame, he came right up to the table where I was sitting. She didn't seem at all afraid. Another view of the dune forest at Vardel, and one of the postcards that the tourism board give out. This next section deals with a trip to the Drakensberg, a little bit of note-taking. But before I went up there, I was staying with my son, and these are his two Boston Terriers and his lovely bonsai. He has a beautiful collection. More bonsai and the Japanese pagoda in his koi pond. And of course, because it was Christmas time, on Christmas Eve, we had a very festive table. This was a quick sketch done before everybody arrived. Lovely red and white theme. Recent additions to his garden include some planter boxes with very sculptural tree aloes. Friend in Underberg. She lives at Castleburn. It's a resort in the Underberg area of the Drakensberg. This is just a corner of her house, which I sketched while we were talking. And Tess, their Labrador, was kind enough to pose for me. Again, I was using the smoky quartz and just diluting it with a water brush. We went for lunch to the Lemon Tree, and this was a drawing I did while we were waiting for our lunch to arrive. The Zimkulu River, Castleburn. There's a lovely area for resort guests to sit underneath the willow trees along the grassy bank, enjoy the river, and generally relax and unwind. While I was sitting there, the storm clouds started to gather, so I tried to capture these in a quick, sketchy way. All too soon it was time to go home. I stopped off at the Old Duck for breakfast. I was sitting underneath a willow tree looking at the donkeys in the paddock next to the cafe and enjoying a croissant with some coffee. And the coffee was complete with a piggy face in the foam. My sister's garden has a beautiful wild iris. These originated in my garden. I then gave her plants and she now has them there, and they're very beautiful. And then a little bit of note-taking, journaling for beginning of the year. And this is Garden Castle, which is the large mountain above Castleburn, which gives the resort its name. And this is Schmink Ultramarine Finest, the most favourite of mine, of the ultramarines. Then back to Westville and a long extended lunch with a friend of mine in the cafe that had all sorts of quirky things. This dressmaker's dummy was one of them, and a rescued tortoise as well in the garden. Then it was all too soon time to pack up, and a sketch of my daughter-in-law's orchids in the airport. I had a photograph and a tree because it was time to wait for the plane. In addition to these two sketchbook inserts, I took two blank paper inserts with me on my holiday, and these were mainly to keep a travel diary. In the front I had a few family photographs, my itinerary. Then I had a little page showing some of my pens and what inks I have in them, a few other important details. And then generally it's mostly writing, interspersed with some photographs that I've printed using the little sprocket printer. So mostly writing, lots of writing. Half-hearted attempt at keeping my finances in order. It didn't work. I enjoyed the combination of writing and photographs for this travel diary.